Hey everyone, Ash here, and if you're like me, you find the new Star Wars canon to be lackluster and unfulfilling. Journey with me to a galaxy far, far away, as we look back at the expanded universe, which filled our imaginations and kept the Star Wars franchise alive for decades before the likes of Rey and Kylo Ren debuted on the big screen. Journey with me into the legends of Star Wars. How did Anakin Skywalker receive his scar? No, not this scar, or these. I'm talking about the scar on the right side of his face, which made its first on-screen appearance near the tail end of the Clone Wars micro-series, which ran from 2003 until 2005. For that answer, we'll have to look to the Dark Horse comic Star Wars Republic, issue 71. The story begins 6 months before Revenge of the Sith. During the battle to take the warship manufacturing world of Rendili during the Clone Wars. Home to Rendili Star Drive, creators of such designs as the Victory-class Star Destroyer and Dreadnought Cruiser, the Rendili government had been overthrown by a pro-separatist regime loyal to Count Dooku. However, the planet's own home fleet, under the command of Jace Dallin, remained loyal to the Republic, making Rendili a contentious battlefield during the Clone Wars. During the conflict, Jedi Master Obi-Wan Kenobi reunites with rogue Jedi Quinlan Vos, who had been working undercover within Dooku's ranks, hoping to gather intelligence and undermine the Sith Lord from within. Together, they join Master Sese Tin in an attempt to prevent the Separatist army from gaining control of the Rendili fleet. Despite Captain Dallin's loyalty to the Republic, not all who served him felt the same way. His own lieutenant, Melor Yago of the Rendili dreadnought Mercel Kaber, stages a mutiny and takes the fleet, hoping to serve the Confederacy. Jedi Knight Anakin Skywalker arrives during the conflict, and together with Kenobi, Vos, and Tin, the Republic takes the day. Dark Jedi Asajj Ventress, hunting Quinlan Vos on Dooku's orders, follows the Jedi back to Coruscant in order to eliminate Vos and carry out her vendetta against Kenobi. However, she runs into Skywalker first, ambushing him in the capital's industrial sector as he views a message left by Padme Amidala. Ventress, threatening harm on the Senator, enrages Skywalker and a lightsaber battle ensues. Both seem evenly matched, and during a sweeping somersault by Ventress, both opponents land seething strikes across each other's face. In his anger, Anakin overpowers Ventress, binding her in live electrical cables and dropping her into the depths of Coruscant. The mutiny at Rendili would leave lasting consequences, as the Galactic Senate would then agree to centralize the home fleet of every Republic world under the command of Supreme Chancellor Palpatine. This consolidation would form the basis for the future Imperial Navy, and Jace Dallin would have the honor of being the first officer to face execution for insubordination at the hands of Darth Vader. For the full story of today's legend, read Star Wars Dreadnoughts of Rendili from Dark Horse. If you want more Legends content, click the thumbs up or subscribe buttons, or just leave a comment down below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all for the next Legend.